friends. I'm Megan, and this is Jesse.
Hey, everybody. Hey, I was wondering, do you have a favorite day of the week?
Ah, good question, Jesse. I think Sundays are my favorite day of the week. That's the day I go to church for Bible study, worship, and see my friends.
Sundays are the best, but I also love Tuesday, especially Tuesday nights.
Haha, let me guess. You love Tuesday nights because that's Tater Tot Tuesday and your mom makes her famous tater tot casserole.
Oh, my tummy sure does love some tater tot casserole. But I love Tuesday nights because that's the night we go to my friend Carolyn's house. A few other friends from church go too.
Oh, that sounds like fun, Jesse. What kind of things do you guys do at Carolyn's house?
All the families pray and eat together, and sometimes we sing songs about Jesus. The grown-ups read the Bible and talk about it, and sometimes I sit with my dad, and other times I go in another room with my friends, and we have our own Bible story time. It's the best.
Jesse, that reminds me of a Bible story about Paul. People visited Paul at his house too and listened to him teach the good news about Jesus.
Do you think they met on Tater Tot Tuesday?
I'm not sure when they met, but the Bible tells us that Paul welcomed everyone who wanted to hear about Jesus. Let's learn more together. Paul spent 3 months on an island after the ship he was on wrecked on the way to Rome. Finally, Paul got onto another ship and went to Rome. He was still a prisoner, but instead of going to jail, Paul was allowed to live by himself in a house. A soldier stayed with him to guard him, and people came to Paul's house to visit. One day, Paul asked the Jewish leaders to talk to him. Paul said, "The Romans wanted to let me go, but the Jews did not want to. I came to speak to the most important ruler in Rome. I haven't done anything wrong." The Jewish leaders wanted to hear more about Paul and what he believed. They knew Paul was a Christian and that many people did not agree with his teachings. So the leaders agreed on a day to meet with Paul. Many leaders came to hear Paul teach about God's kingdom. Paul explained who Jesus is. Jesus is God's son who came to save people from their sins. Some of the Jewish leaders agreed with Paul, but others did not agree. Paul stayed in the house as a prisoner for 2 years. He welcomed everyone who wanted to hear about Jesus. He talked about God's kingdom and about Jesus. He shared the good news that Jesus saves sinners. Many people listened to Paul's words and believed in Jesus. Paul helped people and prayed for them. He trusted in God, and the good news spread throughout Rome and beyond. Paul told others about Jesus even when he was a prisoner. He kept sharing the good news even when people disagreed. The message about Jesus seems silly to some, but everyone who trusts in Jesus will be saved.
God. I will praise your name, for you have accomplished wonders. Isaiah 25, verse 1.
Paul stayed on the island of Malta for 3 months after the ship he was on wrecked while traveling to Rome. Paul healed people who were sick and shared the good news about Jesus with them. The people on the island were grateful for Paul's help. Finally, Paul and the other prisoners got on another ship and continued their journey to Rome. When the ship arrived in Rome, many people came to meet Paul. He was still a prisoner, but instead of going to jail, Paul was allowed to live by himself in a house. A soldier stayed with him to guard him. On his third day in Rome, Paul asked the Jewish leaders to come talk to him. Paul told them, "I haven't done anything wrong. The Jews made me a prisoner in Jerusalem and handed me over to the Romans. The Romans wanted to let me go free, but the Jews objected. So I had to ask to speak to Caesar, the most important ruler in Rome. Still, I haven't done anything wrong." The Jewish leaders had not heard any reports about Paul doing wrong, but they wanted to hear more about what he believed. They did know that Paul was a Christian, and they knew that many people did not agree with the teachings of people called Christians. So, the leaders agreed on a day to meet with Paul. On that day, even more leaders came to hear what Paul had to say. Paul taught all day about God's kingdom. He pointed to the scriptures, the law, and the Old Testament prophets to explain that Jesus is the Messiah. Some of the Jewish leaders agreed with Paul, but others didn't. For 2 whole years, Paul stayed in the house and welcomed everyone who wanted to hear about Jesus. He talked about God's kingdom and about Jesus. He shared the good news of salvation. Many people listened to Paul's words and believed in Jesus. Some were Jews and others were not. The people were filled with joy and hope because they found new life in Jesus. Paul never stopped preaching about Jesus. Even while he was a prisoner, he wrote letters to different churches to encourage them and remind them about God's love. Paul helped people and prayed for them. He trusted in God, and the good news spread throughout Rome and beyond. Being a prisoner in Rome did not stop Paul from sharing his faith. He continued to share the gospel even when people disagreed. The message about Jesus seems foolish to some, but everyone who trusts in Jesus will be saved.
Hi there, I'm Pastor Kevin. It's time for questions from kids. Daniel from Dayton, Ohio asks,
how do I know if I am saved?
That is a phenomenal question. The Bible tells us that Jesus is Lord, and people can only say that and be completely convinced of it through the power of the Holy Spirit. So, how do we know we're saved? We admit that we're sinners. We repent from our sins and believe in the power of the blood of Jesus Christ to save us. That's it. Don't think for one moment that you can save yourself or that God needs your help in doing this. We must always remind ourselves and trust in God and always confess our sins and always repent of the things that we have done that are not pleasing to God. I want to warn you. Some people will think that they are saved by good works and good deeds. No, we do good works and good deeds because Jesus loves us. Listen, that is not the case. We are saved by grace and grace alone. The Bible tells us in Matthew chapter 7 that many people will say, Lord, Lord, we were doing work for you. But Jesus Christ will say, depart from me, I don't even know you. So our work does not save us. The work of the Holy Spirit saves us and reminds us that we are saved by grace through faith alone. Never, ever forget that. Remember, confess, repent, believe, and repeat, and have joy. Why do we have hope and joy like Paul when Jesus saves us from our sins? I would love to hear from you. Do you have a question? Email me at gospelproject.kids@lifeway.com, and next time I might be answering a question from you.